Hello, welcome to the AgriTopus Academy YouTube channel. As you know, in the last class, we have already started the plant breeding and genetics section. Now, this is the second lecture of plant breeding and genetics. So, let's start our lecture. The first topic is genome. A genome is nothing but the haploid set of chromosome of an individual. It is called as genome. Monoploid. A monoploid contain a single chromosome set and are characteristically sterile in nature. This monoploid can be haploid, but all the haploids can't be a monoploid. The haploid means a single set of chromosome which is denoted by N. Now, what are the uses of haploids? Uses of haploids are, it is used for the development of pure lines, for disease resistance, for the development of inbred lines, and for the production of aneuploid. Aneuploid is a condition where two or more chromosomes are added or subtracted from the somatic set of chromosome. Now, next point is double haploid. A double haploid plants are developed from the haploids by doubling the chromosome number of haploid plants. Next topic is polyploidy. The presence of more than two genomes in an individual is known as polyploid. Now, this polyploid are of two types, autopolyploid and allopolyploid. This autopolyploid means all the genomes present in an individual are identical, and when they are all distinct, this is called as allopolyploid. In many species, the autopolyploid show an increase in vigor and size. This phenomena is known as gigantism. Giant ka matlab hota hai bada. To jab bhi autoploid ki condition ki wajah se increased in vigor or size mein increment aa jata hai, is condition ko hum bolte hai gigantism. Now, this autopolyploid includes triploids, tetraploids and pentaploids, depending upon the set of chromosome. Now, first is autotriploids. It is having three set of homologous chromosome. The autotriploids are generally highly sterile due to the defective gamete formation. But these triploids of some species are highly fertile, for example, spinach. The triploids are useful only in those plant species which propagate asexually, like banana, sugarcane and apple. Mostly cultivated varieties of banana are autotriploids and are seedless in nature. Next example is watermelon. The triploid watermelon are seedless and have the capacity of early maturity and disease resistance. These are produced by crossing between tetraploid and diploid. Next example is sugar beets. The triploid sugar beets produce large roots and more sugar content than the diploids. Next is autotetraploid. They are having four copies of same set of chromosome. The tetraploids are usually very stable and fertile because they are having pair partners and are available during meiosis. The example of autotetraploids are rye, grasses, alfalfa, burseem, groundnut and potato. Now, second type of polyploidy is allopolyploidy. Allopolyploidy is a condition where two or more distinct genomes are present, which are derived from different species. The allopolyploid can be developed by interspecific cross. Interspecific cross means a cross between two different species. And their fertility is restored by the chromosome doubling with colchicine treatment. It is found in 50% of the crop plants. The polyploidy is mainly induced treatment with a chemical known as colchicine treatment. The example of these polyploids are wheat, the common bread wheat Triticum astivum. It is an yellow hexaploid, and other examples are tobacco, brassica, cotton. These are allotetraploid. Next important example is triticale. A triticale is a combination of wheat Triticum astivum and rice sickle cereal. Here a intergeneric cross occur between this wheat and rye to derive the combined effect of both the high yield of wheat and disease and drought resistant of rye. The intergeneric cross means a cross between two different genera but having same family. Both the wheat and rye belongs to the same family. Now third condition is aneuploidy, a loss or gain of one or few chromosome as compared to the somatic chromosome number of a species is known as aneuploidy. Aneuploidy का मतलब होता है एक somatic chromosome number means 2n set of chromosome में कुछ भी loss और gain होता है, इस condition को हम aneuploidy बोलते हैं. Now first type of aneuploidy is monosomic. A monosomic is a condition where one chromosome set is absent. The monosomic condition is equals to 2n minus 1 and double monosomic means 2n minus 1 and minus 1. Now second is nullisomic. The absence of a chromosome pair from a diploid set is termed as nullisomic. Nullisomic means 2n minus 2. Third condition is trisomic. An individual having one extra chromosome in the diploid set of chromosome, it is known as 2n plus 1 trisomics. Next is tetrasomics, an individual having one pair of extra chromosome in diploid set of chromosome, it is known as tetrasomic 2n plus 2. Next topic is aneuploidy in men. One of the common syndrome associated with this aneuploidy is the Down syndrome. It is due to the trisomy of chromosome number 21. This Down syndrome causing intellectual disability and developmental delays. It is also known as mongolism. Here the person having short stature about 120 cm. Now the next unit is classical genetics, unit number 6. Firstly, here some terminologies are given. The first is allele. Alleles are the various form of gene. Allele is a pair of genes that occupy a specific location on a particular chromosome and control the same trait. Now the second term is gamete. A gamete refers to a sexual unit. The haploid set of chromosome is also called as gamete. Next is contrasting character. The individual plant features with marked phenotypic difference are known as contrasting character or the traits. For example, red and white color of flower, yellow and green seed coat color, plant height, flower position, flower color. These are the contrasting characters. Now the next term is back cross. The crossing of F1 with one of its parents is known as back cross. जब हम F1 hybrid को parents के साथ cross करते हैं, उसे हम back cross बोलते हैं. ये back cross जो है वो दो type का होता है, test cross and out cross. Test cross means a cross between F1 hybrid with the recessive parent. And outcross means a crossing of F1 hybrid with the dominant parent. Next term is topcross, a cross between an inbred line and an open pollinated variety. It is known as inbred varieties cross. Inbred line ka matlab hota hai closely related species ke beech mein jab crossing hoti hai, isse inbred lines banti hai, like siblings ke beech mein. जब इनब्रीड लाइन और ओपन पॉलिनेटेड वैरायटी के बीच में क्रॉस होता है, इसे हम टॉप क्रॉस बोलते हैं. नाउ द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज मेंडेलियन लॉस. फर्स्ट इज लॉ ऑफ सेग्रीगेशन. द टू एलील्स ऑफ अ जीन्स प्रेजेंट इन F1 डू नॉट कंटामिनेट ईच अदर, दे सेपरेट एंड पास इन टू डिफरेंट गैमेट्स इन देयर ओरिजिनल फॉर्म, प्रोड्यूसिंग टू डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ गैमेट्स इन इक्वल फ्रिक्वेंसी. दिस लॉ इज नोन एज लॉ ऑफ सेग्रीगेशन. The term law of purity of gametes also used to describe this law. Law of segregation का मतलब होता है जब भी F1 hybrid बनता है उसमें दो different gametes होते हैं, capital T एक small t. So these two gametes do not contaminate each other and they separately pass into different gametes. This is known as law of segregation. The next law is law of independent assortment. This law states that when two pairs of gene enter in F1 combination, both of them have their independent dominant effect. Now the next term is gene. Gene is the smallest or the functional part of genetic material. An alternative form of gene is called as allele. A allele means when a gene has two alternative forms, this is known as allele. and multiple allele. The many allele of a single gene are called as multiple allele. In the case of multiple alleles, only the monohybrid ratio is observed in the F2 generation. This controls the same character, and crossing over does not occur in multiple allelism. The example of multiple alleles are fur color in rabbits, wing type in Drosophila, eye color in Drosophila, and AB and O blood group in humans. Multiple allelism का मतलब होता है generally single characters को two genes occupy करते हैं, जैसे कि tall and dwarf. लेकिन multiple allelism condition के अंदर, जैसे कि ABO blood group, human blood group के लिए three genes responsible होते हैं, IB, IB, IA and IO. Next is pseudo alleles. They governs different expression of the same character. They exhibit cis transposition effect. Next topic is types of gene interactions. Here some important ratios are given related to these interactions. First is typical dihybrid ratio for a single trait. It is 9:3:3:1. Second is duplicate gene action. It is 15:1. Complementary gene action 9:7. Supplementary gene action 9:3:4. Inhibitory gene action 13:3. Masking gene action 12:3:1. Polymeric gene action 9:6:1. And additive gene action 1:4:6:4:1. Next term is antigen. An antigen is a molecule of immunogenic which specifically interacts with an antibody. Antigens are the substances that enters in the body and are responsible for different diseases. Next term is antibody. An immunogen is a molecule which when introduced into the system of an animal, it induces the production of a class of proteins that is known as antibodies. These antibodies belong to a class of proteins called immunoglobulins. Whenever these antigens enter in our body forms antibodies which will fight against these antigens. Now the next unit is unit number 7, mutation. Mutation is a sudden inheritable changes in the characters of an organism, and the individual which are showing this heritable changes are known as mutants. Both the chemical and physical agents are responsible for this mutation. The mutation causing agents are called as mutagens. Here some examples of mutagens are given. These mutagens are chemical and physical in nature. First is physical mutagens. These physical mutagens are classified as ionizing radiation and non-ionizing radiation. The example of ionizing radiation are alpha rays, beta rays and gamma rays and X-rays. And the example of non-ionizing radiation are UV rays. And the example of chemical mutagens are mustard gas, 5-bromouracil, acriflavin and ethium bromide. The rate of spontaneous mutation is very low, generally ranges from 10^-4 to 10^-6 for eukaryotes, and for the prokaryotes it is 10^-5 to 10^-7. Now the next topic is linkage. All the genes on a chromosome are said to be linked to one another and they belongs to the linkage group. The phenomena of inheritance of linked gene in some linkage group is called as linkage. It is just opposite to the crossing over. The phases of linkage are, first is coupling, linkage between two or more, either dominant or recessive allele is referred to as coupling. The second is repulsion, linkage of dominant allele with that of recessive allele, it is known as repulsion. कपलिंग में या तो डोमिनेंट पेरेंट्स के बीच में लिंकेज होगा या रेसेसिव पेरेंट्स के बीच में होता है, बट रिपल्शन में लिंकेज होता है एक डोमिनेंट एलील और एक रेसेसिव एलील में. टेस्ट क्रॉस इज द मोस्ट कॉमन मेथड फॉर डिटेक्टिंग द लिंकेज. नेक्स्ट टर्म इज इंटरफेरेंस. दिस इंटरफेरेंस इज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड बाय मुलर. द टेंडेंसी ऑफ वन क्रॉस ओवर टू रिड्यूस द चांस ऑफ अनादर क्रॉस ओवर इन इट्स adjacent region is called as interference. Next term is coincidence. It explains the strength or the degree of interference. Next topic is sex determination. It utilizes various genetically concepts to decide whether a particular individual will develop into a male or a female sex. The sex determining genes are present on both the X chromosome as well as on the autosomes. Next topic is sex-linked characters. The characters for which genes are located on sex chromosome are known as sex-linked traits. Such genes are called as sex-linked genes, and linkage of such genes is referred to as sex linkage. The main feature of sex-linked characters are, first is location. Sex-linked genes are located on X chromosome only. Number, in diploid organism, each homogenetic sex has two copies of linked alleles. Third is expression. In homogametic sex, a recessive gene can express. Heterogametic sex, a recessive allele can express. Next is transmission. The sex-linked genes are transmitted from female to male and not from the male, because the male receives the chromosomes from female only. The sex-linked genes are first inherited from male to female in the first generation and then back to male in the second generation. This type of inheritance, in which a sex-linked genes is inherited from grandfather to grandson through the daughter, it is called as crisscross inheritance. The next topic is examples of the sex-linked characters. First is in Drosophila, white eye and vermilion eye. Second is hemophilia. Hemophilia is a well-known example of sex linkage in human. In case of marriage between hemophilic woman and a normal man, the disease will be transmitted to 50% of the sons, even if the genes is in heterozygous condition in the carrier. Third is color blindness. Color blindness is another example of sex linkage in humans, where sons from the marriage between color blind man and a normal woman will be normal, but daughter will carry such genes in heterozygous condition. Marriage of such carrier girl with colorblind boy will yield children in which both the male and female children will be colorblind, each in 50% cases. Last is sex-limited character. The characters which are expressed in one sex only are referred to as sex-limited character. For example, breast development in women and the beard in men. Now the next unit is unit number 8, protein synthesis. It involves two main processes, transcription and translation. The first is transcription or TeNAism. The process of synthesis of messenger RNA from a DNA template, it is known as transcription. Transcription process mein hum DNA se mRNA form karte hain. It takes place during the interphase and continues up to the prophase of cell division. हमने लास्ट क्लास में सेल डिवीजन के डिफरेंट फेजेस पढ़े थे, प्रोफेज, मेटाफेज, एनाफेज एंड टेलोफेज. सो ट्रांसक्रिप्टेज एंजाइम के प्रेजेंस में डीएनए से एमआरएनए फॉर्म होता है. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज रिवर्स ट्रांसक्रिप्शन. रिवर्स ट्रांसक्रिप्शन में एमआरएनए से डीएनए फॉर्म होता है. इस प्रोसेस को हम रिवर्स ट्रांसक्रिप्शन बोलते हैं. नाउ द सेकेंड टाइप इज ट्रांसलेशन. द प्रोसेस ऑफ प्रोटीन सिंथेसिस फ्रॉम इंफॉर्मेशन इन mRNA इज नोन एज ट्रांसलेशन. ट्रांसलेशन का मतलब होता है जब mRNA से प्रोटीन का सिंथेसिस होता है, इस प्रोसेस को हम ट्रांसलेशन बोलते हैं. नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज साइटोप्लाज्मिक इनहेरिटेंस. मोस्ट ऑफ द फिनोटाइपिक कैरेक्टर्स आर कंट्रोल्ड बाय जीन्स प्रेजेंट इन द क्रोमोसोम्स, बट सम कैरेक्टर्स एक्सप्रेस्ड बाय फैक्टर्स प्रेजेंट इन द साइटोप्लाज्म. दिस फैक्टर्स लाइंग इन द साइटोप्लाज्म आर कॉल्ड एज प्लाज्मा जीन्स. जनरली जो फिनोटाइपिक कैरेक्टर्स होते हैं, एक्सटर्नल कैरेक्टर्स हैं, वो क्रोमोसोम के अंदर जो जीन्स प्रेजेंट होते हैं उनसे कंट्रोल होते हैं. लेकिन साइटोप्लाज्मिक इनहेरिटेंस के अंदर ये जो कैरेक्टर्स हैं वो साइटोप्लाज्म के जीन्स से एक्सप्रेस्ड होते हैं, और इन जीन्स को हम प्लाज्मा जीन्स बोलते हैं. So the transmission of characters controlled by plasma genes is called as cytoplasmic inheritance. The first case of cytoplasmic inheritance was reported by Correns in 1909 in 4 o'clock, that is Mirabilis jalapa, for the leaf color. It is used for the development of cytoplasmic male sterility lines in several crops like maize, pearl millet and sorghum. Next unit is plant breeding. Here some contribution of breeders are given. First is Thomas Fairchild. He developed first interspecific hybrid between sweet William and Carnation species of Dianthus. Second scientist is Rimpu. He made the first intergeneric cross between bread wheat and rye to give the birth of triticale. The DT46 is the variety of triticale. Third is Jones. He made a double cross in maize, used genetic male sterility in the development of maize hybrid. Next person is Vavilov. The center of origin was given by Vavilov. He identified 8 main centers and 3 sub-centers of crop diversity. Next person is Nagaharu, the tetraploid species of Brassica using a triangle which is responsible as U-triangle. Harrington, he proposed mass pedigree method of breeding, which is the modification of pedigree method. Next person is Flor H.H. He developed the concept of gene for gene hypothesis in flax for flax rust caused by Melanospora linii. Next is Van der Planck. He developed the concept of vertical and horizontal resistance. And Donald, the crop ideotype working with wheat. Now the next topic is breeding method. First breeding method is pure line selection. It is given by Johnson. It refers to the homogeneous progeny of self-pollinated homozygous plant. The development of new variety through the identification and isolation of single best plant progeny is known as pure line selection or the individual plant selection. This method is commonly used in self-pollinated species like wheat and barley. Second method is mass selection method. It refers to a method of crop improvement in which individual plants are selected on the basis of phenotyping from a mixed population. The seeds are bulked and used to grow the next generation. This is one of the oldest method of crop improvement. Mass selection is applicable to both the self and cross-pollinated species, but mostly it is applicable for the cross-pollinated crops, for example maize, pearl millet, mustard, and often cross-pollinated crops like cotton and sorghum. Third is clonal selection. The progenies of a single plant obtained by asexual reproduction is known as a clone. ऐसी प्रोजेनी जो अपने पेरेंट्स से आइडेंटिकल होती है इसे हम क्लोन बोलते हैं. द क्रॉप्स विच आर प्रोपेगेटेड एसेक्सुअली और बाय वेजिटेटिव मीन्स आर नोन एज एसेक्सुअली प्रोपेगेटेड और वेजिटेटिवली प्रोपेगेटेड और द क्लोनल क्रॉप्स. नेक्स्ट इज पेडिग्री मैथड. अ पेडिग्री रेफर्स टू अ रिकॉर्ड ऑफ द एंसेस्ट्री ऑफ एन इंडिविजुअल सेलेक्टेड प्लांट्स. द पेडिग्री ब्रीडिंग इज अ मैथड ऑफ जेनेटिक इम्प्रूवमेंट ऑफ सेल्फ पॉलिनेटेड स्पीशीज in which superior genotype are selected from the segregating generation and proper record of the ancestor of selected plants are maintained in each generation. Pedigree method में हम हर एक generation के बाद selection करते हैं. यहाँ पे selection important होता है. The application of pedigree method is, it is widely used for the improvement of self-pollinated species for the development of new varieties. While in cross-pollinated species, it is used for the development of inbreed lines. Next method is bulk breeding method. The selection refers to a selection procedure in which segregation population of self-pollinated species is grown in bulk plot. This method is also known as mass or the population method. This method is used for the genetic improvement of self-pollinated crop plants. Next is backcross method. The backcross refers to the crossing of F1 with either of its parent. When the F1 is crossed with homozygous recessive parent, it is known as a test cross. And backcross method is applicable in all three groups of plant like self-pollinated, cross-pollinated and asexually propagated. Backcross method has been widely used for the development of disease-resistant varieties in both the self and cross-pollinated species of wheat and cotton. It has also been used for the interspecific gene transfer development of multi-line varieties in self-pollinated species. Last is recurrent selection. A reselection generation after generation with interbreeding of selects to provide the genetic recombination. It was originally developed as a method of breeding cross-pollinated species, but now it is also used for self-pollinated species. So these are some important breeding methods. Now the next unit is unit number 10, seed technology. What is a seed? A seed is a fertilized ovule consisting of intact embryo, stored food and seed coat which is viable and has got the capacity to germinate. The National Seed Act passed in 1966 and National Seed Corporation in 1963. Next topic is classes of seeds. First is nuclear seed. Such seeds are the initial seeds of an improved variety and are available in limited quantity. It is produced directly by the originating plant breeder at the research institute. It has highest genetic purity of about 100%. Nucleus seed ko hum initial seed bolte hain. Nucleus seed se breeder seed form hota hai. Isiliye hum breeder seed ko progeny of nucleus seed bolte hain. Second is breeder seed. It is produced under strict supervision of plant breeder at the research institute. Breeder seed is used to produce foundation seed. The genetic and physical purity is almost same as the nucleus seed, almost 100%. It has golden yellow color tag. Breeder seed or nucleus seed, dono hi seed ko research institute mein banate hain plant breeders. और इनका जेनेटिक प्योरिटी परसेंटेज होता है 100%. थर्ड इज फाउंडेशन सीड. इट इज अ प्रोजेनी ऑफ ब्रीडर सीड. इट इज नोन एज मदर सीड एज इट इज अ सोर्स ऑफ रजिस्टर्ड एंड द सर्टिफाइड सीड क्लासेस. इट इज जेनेटिकली 99.9% प्योर एंड फिजिकली 98%. इट इज मेनली प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय नेशनल सीड कॉरपोरेशन NSC. It is produced on government farms, at experiment station, agriculture university or on cultivators field under the strict supervision of research scientist and expert from the state seed certification agency. And foundation seed ka color tag hota hai white. Fourth is registered seed. It is produced from the foundation seed or registered seed. अभी रजिस्टर्ड सीड से कैसे बनता है? तो रजिस्टर्ड सीड क्लास फर्स्ट से रजिस्टर्ड सीड क्लास सेकंड बनती है. इट हैज सेटिस्फैक्ट्री जेनेटिक आइडेंटिटी एंड प्योरिटी. इन इंडिया इट इज जनरली ओमिटेड और अवॉइडेड एंड सर्टिफाइड सीड इज प्रोड्यूस्ड डायरेक्टली फ्रॉम द फाउंडेशन सीड. इट हैज पर्पल और ऑरेंज कलर टैग. And the last is certified seed. It is a progeny of either the registered seed or the foundation seed or certified seed itself. It has a satisfactory genetic identity and purity. It is approved and certified by the state seed certifying agency. The bags are denoted by blue color tag. It is available for the general distribution to the farmers for commercial crop production. So these are the important 5 classes of seeds. First is nucleus seed, jisse banta hai breeder seed. Then breeder seed se banta hai foundation seed. Foundation seed se registered seed and registered seed se certified seed bante hain. Next topic is viability of seeds. Seed viability is defined as the capability of seed to remain capable of germination for some specific period of time. सीड वायबिलिटी एक पीरियड होता है जिसमें हम सीड सोइंग कर सकते हैं और सीड जर्मिनेट कर सकता है. नेक्स्ट सीड वायबिलिटी टेस्ट. फर्स्ट टेस्ट इज पोटेशियम परमैंगनेट मेथड. इट इज अ क्वालिटेटिव टेस्ट टू फाइंड आउट वेदर द सीड आर वायबल और नॉट. नेक्स्ट इज टेट्राजोलियम क्लोराइड टेस्ट. इट इज नोन एज बायोलॉजिकल टेस्ट. द सीड्स आर सॉक्ड इन 0.5 to 2% सॉल्यूशन ऑफ 235 ट्राइफिनाइल टेट्राजोलियम क्लोराइड सॉल्यूशन. The viable or living seeds take bright red coloration and the color become more intense in the embryo. It is the quickest method of viability test. Third is Grodex test. Grodex is a seed germination indicator. It's a brand name of triphenyl tetrazolium bromide in powder form. Next topic is isolation distance. The isolation of seed crop is essential to avoid the genetic and physical impurity. क्रॉप इम्प्रूवमेंट मैथड्स के लिए हम आइसोलेशन डिस्टेंस मेंटेन करते हैं जिससे हम क्रॉप की फिजिकल एंड जेनेटिक इम्प्योरिटी को अवॉइड कर सकते हैं. द मिनिमम आइसोलेशन रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ सम क्रॉप्स आर गिवन. फर्स्ट इज फॉर द सेल्फ पॉलिनेटेड क्रॉप्स लाइक राइस वीट बार्ले ओट. फॉर फाउंडेशन सीड एंड सर्टिफाइड सीड द आइसोलेशन डिस्टेंस इज 3 meters. फॉर पर्ल मिलेट हाइब्रिड द आइसोलेशन इज foundation seed it is 400 and for certified seed it is 200 meters. For maize and sorghum it is for the foundation seed it is 400 and for certified seed it is 200 meters. For cotton hybrid for the foundation seed it is 50 and for certified seed it is 30 meters. For groundnut and soybean in foundation seed it is 3 meters and for certified seed it is also 3 meters. For rapeseed and mustard for the foundation seed it is 400 meters and for certified seeds it is 200 meters. In cucurbits for foundation seed it is 800 meters and for certified seed it is 400 meters. In okra for foundation it is 400 meters and for certified seed it is 200 meters. In tomato for foundation seed is 50 meters, for certified seed it is 25 meters, for onion 1000 meters for both the foundation and certified seeds. The next topic is real value of seed. It is the percentage of germinability of percentage of purity of seed lot of a crop plant. It is given by purity percentage into germination percentage by 100. It is expressed in percentage and also known as utility percentage of seed. The impurity percentage is called as dockage. The genetic purity is required 100% as far as an impurity of seeds of other varieties of same crop is concerned, but in case of impurity by seeds or other crop species, it is permitted up to 0.1% only in foundation seed and 0.5% in other seeds. Next is seed index. The weight of 100 seeds is called a seed index. This seed index is used in case of bold seeds like gram and maize. Next term is test weight. The weight of 1000 seeds are called as test weights. Test weight hum small seeds ke liye count karte hain aur seed index hum large seeds ke liye aur bold seeds ke liye count karte hain. Next is seed quality index. It is a vigor of seed germination. The germination percentage in maize is 90%, highest in the field crop, and in cotton germination the percentage is 65%, that is lowest among the field crops. Next topic is seed dormancy. The inability of viable seed to germinate even under the optimal condition provided for germination is called as seed dormancy. सीड डॉर्मेंसी को हम रेस्टिंग पीरियड भी बोलते हैं. सीड डॉर्मेंसी का मतलब होता है उस टाइम पे सीड जर्मिनेट नहीं कर सकता है. सीड डॉर्मेंसी को ब्रेक करने के लिए डिफरेंट मेथड्स होते हैं. फर्स्ट इज स्कैरिफिकेशन एंड सेकेंड इज स्ट्रेटिफिकेशन. एनी ट्रीटमेंट दैट इज फिजिकल और केमिकल दैट वीकेंस द सीड कोट इट इज कॉल्ड एज स्कैरिफिकेशन. इन सम कंडीशन ड्यू टू द हार्ड सीड कोट सीड रिमेन डॉर्मेंट. और सीड कोट को वीकेंड करने के लिए हम स्कैरिफिकेशन मेथड यूज करते हैं जिसमें हम KNO3 और थायो यूरिया को यूज करते हैं. दिस थायो यूरिया इज मेनली यूज इन केस ऑफ पोटेटो. सेकेंड मेथड इज स्ट्रेटिफिकेशन. द सीड्स आर सब्जेक्ट्स इनटू टेम्परेचर ट्रीटमेंट और द चिलिंग ट्रीटमेंट. फॉर चिलिंग ट्रीटमेंट सीड्स आर कैप्ट एट 2 to 8 degrees Celsius फॉर 12 to 24 hours. Now the next topic is seed plot technique of potato. This technique was developed by Paul Ehrlich in 1906. Pushkarnath in 1967, it is a technique of multiplication of disease-free or the virus-free seeds in northern plains of country. The viruses are transmitted by aphids. The nucleus seed of potato is produced during April to August when the aphid population is low in hilly areas. It is brought to plains and it is stored in cold storage for planting the seed crop in October. Other categories of seeds are orthodox seeds and recalcitrant seeds. Orthodox seeds, the seeds remain viable for long time at low temperature and low moisture content. They don't lose their viability at low temperature, for example, the seeds of cereals and beans. In recalcitrant seeds, the seeds don't remain viable for long time at low moisture and low temperature condition because they show very drastic loss of viability with decrease in moisture content below 12 to 14%, for example in mango and coconut seeds. Orthodox seeds ko hum long time ke liye low temperature and low moisture content par store kar sakte hain jaise ki cereals or bean seeds. लेकिन recalcitrant seeds को हमें high moisture content पे store करना पड़ता है, that is greater than 12 to 14%. Next topic is Seed Act. The Seed Act was enacted by the Parliament on 1966 and the Seed Rule was notified in 1968. This act came into force throughout the country on 2nd October 1969. Seeds was declared as an essential commodity under the Essential Commodity Act 1955. Next is Seed Production Agency. The first is National Seed Corporation. It was registered in 1963 having objectives of to promote the development of seed industry in India and to produce and supply foundation seeds of various crop. Second is State Seed Corporation. It is concerned with production and supply of certified seed and to reduce the workload of National Seed Corporation. Third is AgMark. According to the Agriculture Production Act 1937, it's used national mark to express the quality and purity of agriculture and animal products. The central laboratory of AgMark is situated at Nagpur. Now the last unit is terminology. Here some terminologies are given related to the plant breeding and genetics. The first term is genetics. Genetics is a branch of biology which is concerned with the study of heredity and variation. Second is eugenics. The application of principle of genetics for the improvement of humankind is called as eugenics. Third point is gene pool, the sum total of all the alleles present in the breeding or reproductive members of a random mating population is called as gene pool. Gene frequency, the proportion of one allele relative to all the alleles of a gene in the Mendelian population is called as gene frequency. Next is cytogenetics. It is concerned with the study of various aspects of chromosome and their effects on the development of characters of organism. Next is the genome. A complete set of chromosome of a diploid species is called as genome. The first artificial hybrid in plants were produced by Thomas Fairchild in 1717 when the crossed occur between Sweet William with Carnation. Next is euphonics. The euphonics deals with the control of hereditary diseases, especially inborn errors of metabolism. Next term is epistasis. When one gene affects in any way the expression of another gene, this phenomena is called as epistasis. जब एक जीन दूसरे जीन को अफेक्ट करता है, इस कंडीशन को हम epistasis बोलते हैं. Next term is genomics. It refers to the study of structure and function of entire genome of an organism is called as genomics. जब भी हम किसी individual के genome की study करते हैं, उसके structure या function की, उसे हम genomics बोलते हैं. Next term is biodiversity. It refers to the total variability present within and among species of all living organism and their habitats are called as biodiversity. Next is acclimatization. It refers to the adaptation or adjustment of an introduced variety to the new environment is called as acclimatization. Next is A line. It means the male sterile parent used in crossing to develop a new hybrid seed. It is a male sterile line. B line, it is a fertile counter parent of A line. It is also called as maintainer line. Third is R line. It is an inbred line which when crossed with a male sterile strain, the resultant hybrid is a male fertile. इसे हम restored line बोलते हैं. Next is in vitro. The biochemical process taking place in test tube is called as in vitro. And in vivo means a biological process taking place in a living cell or organism. Next is crisscross inheritance. The inheritance of sex-linked genes from grandfather to grandson through the daughter, it is called as crisscross inheritance. Next term is gene cloning. The isolation of a gene and the process of producing identical copies is known as gene clone. Gene clone का मतलब होता है जब भी हम identical copies बनाते हैं उसे हम clone बोलते हैं. Next is electroporation. It is a technique which uses electrical discharge to produce pores on cell membrane for the intact of recombinant DNA. Next term is heterosis. The superiority of F1 in one or more characters over its parent is known as heterosis or the hybrid vicar. Heterosis term का मतलब होता है जब progeny अपने parents के comparison में superior होती है, इस condition को हम heterosis या फिर hybrid vicar बोलते हैं. Next is heterobeltosis. Next term is heterobeltosis. When the F1 is found superior to either of the parents, it is known as heterobeltosis. Next term is allogamy or the cross-pollination. The pollen grains from flower of one plant transferred to the receptive stigma of the flower of another plant, it is known as allogamy. Next term is self-pollination or the autogamy. The pollen grains from one anther fall on the receptive stigma of same flower is known as self-pollination. Next term is chasmogamy. The flowers open but only after the pollination takes place. For example, in moong, the flowers does not open at all, ensuring the complete self-pollination. For example, in wheat and cereals. Next term is gytenogamy. The pollen grains from flowers of one plant fall on the receptive stigma of other flowers of the same plant is known as gytenogamy. For example, in maize. Maize is a monoecious type of plant. इसीलिए इसके अंदर जिटेनोगेमी होती है. नेक्स्ट इज मोनोशियस. मोनोशियस मीन्स बोथ द मेल एंड फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव स्ट्रक्चर आर फाउंड ऑन द सेम प्लांट बट इन सेपरेट फ्लावर्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन मेज. नेक्स्ट टर्म इज डायोशियस. द मेल एंड फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव स्ट्रक्चर्स आर फाउंड ऑन द सेपरेट प्लांट्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन पपाया एंड डेट पाम. Next term is pseudo-heterosis. The superiority of F1 over its parents in vegetative growth but not in yield and adaptation is called as luxuriance and pseudo-heterosis. Next term is inbreeding. The mating between closely related individuals such as selfing and submating is called as inbreeding. Next is inbreeding depression. The loss or decrease in vigor and fitness as a result in inbreeding is known as inbreeding depression. Next is double cross hybrid. The hybrid progeny from a cross between two single crosses, for example, a cross between ABCD and their individual crosses. Next is top cross. A cross between an inbred line and an open pollinated variety is known as top cross. Next is synthetic varieties. A varieties which is developed by intermating in all possible combination a number of inbred lines with a good general combining ability and mixing the seed of F1 crosses in equal quantity is referred to as synthetic variety. Second is composite varieties. In cross-pollinated crops, a variety developed by mixing the seed of various genotype which are similar in maturity, height, seed size, seed color, or the mixture of genotypes from several sources that is maintained in bulk from one generation to the next, it is referred to as composite varieties. Their examples are Vijay, Ambar, Shakti are the varieties of maize. So this is all about plant breeding and genetics. Next lecture mein hum plant physiology start karne wale. So thanks for watching and don't forget to like, subscribe and share.